were very much understood by you. Our next concept is weighted average. If we have two or more groups of numbers whose individual average is given to us, then by combining the individual values with their averages, we get the weighted average. If say n1, n2, n3, n4 and so on have the average of a1, a2, a3, a4 and so on, then the weighted average of this data will be n1 a1 plus n2 a2 plus n3 a3 so on divided by n1 plus n2 plus n3 and so on. This is the formula for weighted average. I hope this is clear. Let us now look at few examples to understand this concept in a better way. The example on your screen now reads, the average score of a cricketer in 2 matches is 27 and in 3 matches is 32. Then find the average score in all 5 matches. Let us look at the solution of this. The average score of the cricketer in first 2 matches was 27 and in next 3 matches was 32. Therefore, if we apply our formula of AW is equal to N1 A1 plus N2 A2 divided by N1 plus N2, we get 2 into the average of that, which is 27, plus 3 into the average of that, which is 32, divided by 2 plus 3. Which gives us the value 54 plus 96 by 5, which is 30. Hence, the average score of cricketer in 5 matches is 30. Let us now look at another example. The example on your screen reads, the average age of students of a class is 15.8 years. The average age of boys in the class is 16.4 years and that of girls is 15.4 years. The ratio of number of boys to number of girls in the class is option A 1:2, option B 2:3, option C 3:4 and option D 3:5. Now let us consider that the number of boys in the class are x and number of girls in class are y. With this we get sum of ages of boys is equal to x into 16.4, which can be written as 16.4x. also sum of ages of girls will be 15.4y. Now, the average of the whole class age is given as 15.8. Therefore, this can be 15.8 into x plus y. This will be the total age of the whole class, which will be equal to the sum of ages of boys 16.4x plus 15.4y. After solving this equation, we get 0.6x is equal to 0.4y. Therefore, 0.6 upon 0.4 is equal to y by x. 2:3 will be the answer of this question. That is option B. Let us now consider another example for a better understanding. The example on your screen now reads, the average of 6 numbers is 3.95. The average of 2 of them is 3.4, while the average of the other 2 is 3.85. What is the average of the remaining 2 numbers? Option A 4.5, option B 4.6, option C 4.7 and option D 4.8. Look at this now. The question says that the average of 6 numbers is 3.95, out of which 2 numbers examples give the average of 3.5 and the other two give the average of 3.85. Now we are asked to find out the average of the other two number. So using the concept of weighted mean over here, 6 into 3.95 minus 2 into 3.5 minus 2 into 3.85 will give us this value. After solving this, we get 23.70 minus 6.8 minus 7.7, which gives us 9.20. Hence, the required average of remaining two numbers will be 9.20. Let us look at this once again. This will be the total value of six numbers, the sum of all the numbers in this set. And this will be the sum of two numbers in this set. And this is the sum of two numbers in this set. Therefore, since we have to find this, we simply subtract the sum of both of these from this.